and May, which where the temperature ranges from 36 degrees to 37 degrees. By using the data from the sunpath diagram, I have come to a conclusion of horizontal shading devices in this manner. This is a light shelf which I have used for the lowest most windows where the light gets reflected and indirect light comes in. Here you can see that in this part direct light comes in the month of March and December. To avoid this, you can have horizontal shades given here, which will provide indirect light, which is good for reading and provides good environment. The vertical shading devices which I've incorporated here are in proper 90 angles and 45 angles. It improves the insulation value of the glass in winter and also reduces the harmful sun rays from coming into the interiors. Calculations to derive the height and the width of the windows or any openings have been found out here for all the angles, for all the directions such as south, west, east and north. Here I've used the skylights for the AV hall and the art gallery. The skylights have been given this so that the light gets reflected and goes onto the water body, which is below the art gallery, and gets reflected. This will even cool the atmosphere. The water body below there will cool the atmosphere and reflect a lot of light as well. On the uppers, where there are planters below, I've provided a small skylight in this manner, which has a small seating on this side. So it will be on a comfortable height and a seating is provided. This is a model of a tourist center that is designed in Chandigarh. There are two blocks. The model is divided into two blocks. This is the admin block, the art gallery, the souvenir shop, information desk. All comes in this block, and this block covers the pantry, the sitting area, cafe, and washrooms. This comes in the get together space that will be here. It has step down stairs. This is like it's underground. Half of it is underground. Now for the art gallery as well as for the AV hall, we do not need a lot of natural light. So it depends on the artificial light. So we have these underground. Here I've given few skylights which are projecting out as seatings when you go from top. Now you can access the this top point from the from this point, which will give you the view of the open hand totally. These are few steps, stair steps, which are designed just as a placement for relaxing. Under different conditions, like weather conditions, this can be covered with tensile structures using these the parapet around. I've provided vertical fence here and horizontal fence on this side for protection. So here, this is the entry for this block, which is provided with a ramp, and these are the planters between every room or every section. This is provided to above with a skylight that can be used as ventilators, and to and as this structure is underground, it will not be suffocating in there. Also, I've provided vertical gardening here, which will be aesthetically pleasing, as well as it will have an effect of freshness. Water bodies have been given here to make the atmosphere a bit cooler during the hot seasons. Here, if you see that the side fences, the side facing north, south north direction, so vertical fence have been provided on this direction. The window sizes are calculated according to the sunpath. Here, as this part of the structure points on the west side, I've provided vertical lures that move according to the sun rays. Now this is the path that a person can follow to climb up onto this level for viewing the open hand. This has been designed as green roof to keep the below structure cool and to protect it from the harsh sun. As this remains cool, the interior will also remain cool. These are the skylights provided. These are the pergolas which will give different shadows at different times of the day. The wall assembly that I have used here is a ferrocrete wall and a cavity wall. The cavity wall reduces the heat intake inside and keeps the interior cooler. And even in the olden palaces such as Agra Fort, the water was added into this cavity wall to keep it cooler. But right now, even leaving this amount of space here would be beneficial. A ferrocrete wall has been used on the for the underground to keep it strong and resistant towards the earthquakes. The cavity wall also gives a better insulation from the underground water. These are the roof assemblies and the section for it. As the climate there is warm and humid, so we have this value 0.33. According to that, I've selected this slab. And on the slab we'll have these stones and a cocoa pit and lightweight soil, and then we can do the plantation on top of this. As you can see, my structure is partially underground, so I have used this kind of a system where the drainage pipes are here, which will let the drain water to come out from here, and the thickness of this slab is 450. Waterproofing has been given both inside and outside to keep it more secured from dampness. For the ventilation of the basement, ventilators have been provided. Blowers or exhaust fans can also be provided. So the sustainable strategies that I've used is first the green roof, which will keep the inner structure cool, and water bodies that have been incorporated inside as well as outside the structure, which will keep it cool and during summers and warm during winters. Then skylights have been used, which will help in ventilation as well as to provide indirect light. Ventilators have been provided where the structure is underground. Also, this exercise has always helped me to understand my design better and to make it more better for the users. It's not just a design that is going to be gonna stand on the ground. It's a design designed for users. So it should give a comfort to the users, and they shouldn't feel trapped in it. They should feel open and enjoy the view or the structure that is there. I've used vertical gardening as well, which provides aesthetically pleasing and also provides a effect of freshness. This, as I can see in my future, this can help me to make better designs even in the smallest of possibilities, like where the light is not a lot. Or a compact situation, so a skylight can always help to make it more brighter wherever possible. And this can be used in most of the designs. This climatical analysis should not be the last thing that you look into. It should be the first thing, and it should be taken care of.